The Regrets of Genius, Five Great Scientists Haunted by Their Own Inventions. Hey there, welcome back to our channel Curiosity Senses. Today, we're diving deep into the fascinating and often haunting stories of five brilliant scientists who, despite their groundbreaking inventions, found themselves haunted by their own creations. So, grab a comfy seat and let's get started. Orville Wright, The Bittersweet Flight of the Airplane. Our journey begins with the legendary Wright brothers, pioneers of aviation. Orville and Wilbur Wright's invention, the airplane, catapulted humanity into the skies. But what they couldn't have foreseen was how their creation would be used in the theater of war. Orville Wright, in 1909, sold planes to the U.S. Army for observation purposes during World War I. But witnessing the destruction these flying machines caused deeply troubled him. In a poignant letter to the Aircraft Production Board, Orville wrote, "The aeroplane has made war so terrible that I do not believe any country will again care to start a war." And 5 years later, on a radio broadcast, Orville expressed that the airplane had, in an unexpected twist, become a powerful instrument for peace. A poignant reminder of the duality of innovation. Mikhail Kalashnikov, from defender to unintended enabler. Next, we delve into the story of Mikhail Kalashnikov, the brilliant mind behind the iconic AK-47 designed to defend his homeland. The Avtomat Kalashnikova model 1947, that is AK-47, became one of the world's deadliest weapons, sought after by terrorists due to its simplicity and affordability. Kalashnikov, torn between pride and remorse, once said, "I'm proud of my invention, but I'm sad that it is used by terrorists. I would prefer to have invented the machine that people could use to help farmers with their work, for example, a lawnmower." Arthur Golston, the botanist whose research turned toxic. Now let's turn our attention to Arthur Golston, an American botanist who aimed to help plants flourish. His research on triiodobenzoic acid, TIBA, accelerated soybean flowering but tragically ended up in the hands of biological warfare scientists. He felt guilty about how his research was used as a chemical weapon for the rest of his life, even though he knew he wasn't to blame for its misuse. Golston carried a deep sense of guilt, stating, "You know, nothing that you do in science is guaranteed to result in benefits for mankind. Any discovery, I believe, is morally neutral and it can be turned either to constructive ends or destructive ends. That's not the fault of science." Alfred Nobel, the explosive legacy of dynamite. Our journey continues with Alfred Nobel, renowned for his groundbreaking work and the Nobel Peace Prize. Surprisingly, his dedication to peace stemmed from his most famous invention, dynamite, initially designed for safer construction. Patented in 1867, Nobel made dynamite as a safer, more stable construction explosive to nitroglycerin, which killed his younger brother Emil. But unfortunately, dynamite soon became a weapon in wars and it killed thousands of people at a time. Nobel was upset by this and that's why he devoted the bulk of his inheritance to establish the Peace Prize. Robert Oppenheimer, father of the atomic bomb. Einstein's regret about the atomic bomb is well known, but he wasn't truly involved in the making of it. Julius Robert Oppenheimer was. A gifted physicist with an interest in nuclear motion and Hindu spirituality, he helped begin an American pursuit of theoretical physics in disciplines such as astrophysics, nuclear physics, and quantum field theory. His research laid the groundwork for what we now know as black holes, but when World War II broke out, he eagerly turned his attention to creating an atomic bomb as a way to end it. The result was Trinity. It exploded with the force of 18,000 tons of TNT. Oppenheimer never forgot that test, nor its magnitude, as he explained in a special TV broadcast. We knew the world would not be the same. A few people laughed. A few people cried. Most people were silent. I remembered the line from the Hindu scripture, the Bhagavad Gita. Vishnu is trying to persuade the prince that he should do his duty and, to impress him, takes on his multi-armed form and says, "Now I am become death, the destroyer of worlds." I suppose we all thought that, one way or another, in some sort of crude sense, which no vulgarity, no humor, no overstatement can quite extinguish, the physicists have known sin, and this is a knowledge which they cannot lose. And there you have it, the stories of these five remarkable scientists who, despite their genius, grappled with the unintended consequences of their inventions. Their experiences serve as powerful reminders of the moral dilemmas that often accompany groundbreaking discoveries. If you know of any other scientists with similar stories or have more topics you'd like us to explore, don't forget to share them in the comments below. And as always, hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss another captivating video on our channel. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you in the next one.